Hello everyone, this is Funny. You are watching Funny HS Info. Today I am going to talk about safe storage of hazardous chemicals. The safe storage of hazardous chemicals is an essential part of an environment, health and safety program. Chemical storage facilities must meet certain minimum standards to satisfy diverse regulations. The most important reasons for proper chemical storage are to provide effective management of chemicals, lessen the risks of fire, prevent accidental mixing in emergencies, to minimize exposure to corrosive and toxic chemicals, and to comply with relevant statutory security obligations. In addition, laboratories and work areas must observe several requirements that incorporate safe storage. They are keeping an up-to-date chemical inventory, maintaining a chemical hygiene plan and documenting staff training, and third one, conducting annual self-inspections. Chemical families or materials should always be segregated and stored according to their chemical family or hazard classification. Do not store chemicals alphabetically unless they are compatible. Before going to talk about the safe storage, let us see some possible hazards due to improper storage of chemicals. Mechanical damage of containers or shelves due to overloading of shelves, uneven or sloped floors in the storage room, tilting or tripping of stored goods. Second one, physical or chemical induced aging of the chemical containers or shelves. The duration of the storage decrease in elasticity and brittleness of the plastic. Metal become brittle. Next one, physical or chemical induced effect in stored goods like cold crystallization, cracking of bottles with aqueous solutions, etc. Next one, open handling like filling and decanting. Next one, fire and explosion. Health hazards like irritation, poisoning, burn or corrosion, breathlessness, suffocation, etc. Next one, environment damage and property damage. These are the hazards which may arise due to improper storage of chemicals. The main classification of chemicals are flammables, corrosive acids and bases, oxidizers, toxic or poisonous, compressor gases, explosives, cryogens, water reactives, and pyrophorics. Let us see how to store these chemicals safely. Always follow material safety data sheets for proper storage of chemicals and follow this chart. In this chart, the green indicates the chemicals are allowed to be stored together. Yellow indicates the chemicals are allowed to be stored together, subjected to special precautions. And red indicates the chemicals are not allowed to be stored together. For example, if you take corrosive, these can be stored with corrosive and irritant materials. With the special precautions, they may be stored near toxics, and do not store with flammables, oxidizing and explosive chemicals. Flammable liquids, these chemicals are easily ignited and may present a serious fire and explosion hazards. Flammable liquids have a flash point below 100 degree Fahrenheit. Combustible liquids have a flash point of 100 degree Fahrenheit to 200 degree Fahrenheit. Flammable solids have an ignition temperature below 212 degree Fahrenheit. The examples of flammable liquid are acetone and methanol. Acetone or propane is an organic compound. The storage instructions for flammable liquids: avoid storing flammables in direct sunlight or near heat source. Keep area dry and cool. Flammables should be segregated from acids, bases and oxidizers. Keep quantities to a minimum amount over 2 gallons approximately. Use internally spark-free refrigerators designed for chemical storage. And Store in an approved flammable cabinets with required signages. Next one, corrosive acids and bases. Acid is any hydrogen containing substance that is capable of donating a proton to another substance. Acidic substances are usually identified by the sore test. A base is a molecule or ion able to accept a hydrogen ion from an acid. Bases are characterized by a bitter taste and slippery texture. Examples of flammable liquids are sulfuric acid, is a strong mineral acid that has a colorless when pure. For bases, sodium hydroxide, also known as lye or caustic soda, is an inorganic compound with a formula NaOH. The safe storage instructions for corrosive acids and bases. Store in approved corrosive cabinets or in compatible secondary containment. Bases should be segregated from acids, flammables and reactives. Acids should be segregated from bases and flammables. Segregate acids from chemicals which could generate toxics or flammable gases upon contact, such as sodium cyanide. Oxidizing acids are incompatible with most chemicals, especially organics. Next one, oxidizers. Oxidizers are fire hazard. They will readily decompose under certain conditions to yield oxygen or react to promote or initiate the combustion of flammable or combustible materials. Examples of oxidizers are ammonium nitrate. Ammonium nitrate is a chemical compound with a chemical form NH4NO3, and nitrogen dioxide is a chemical compound with a formula NO2. Storage instructions for oxidizers. Must be stored to avoid contact with incompatible materials such as flammables and combustible liquids, greases. Do not store under sink. Avoid storage on wooden shelves, flammables and reactives. Segregate oxidizers from reducing agents like zinc, alkali metals, alkaline metals, formic acid. Segregate inorganic oxidizers from organic peroxides. And liquid oxidizers such as ammonium persulfate and H2O2 react with nearly everything. Fourth one, toxics or poisons. Overexposure to toxic chemicals can cause injury or death. Toxic chemicals are with lethal dose of more than 50 and lethal dose of 100 milligrams per kg body weight, or a lethal concentration in the air of more than 200 and less than 1000 ppm. Examples for toxics and poisons are sodium cyanide is a poisonous compound with a formula NaCN. It is a white water-soluble solid. Aniline is an organic compound with a formula C6H5NH2. It has the odor of rotten fish. How to store toxics or poisons safely? Segregate toxics from other hazard classes and store in a cool, well-ventilated area away from light and heat. Container should be tightly sealed to minimize exposure to personnel and contamination of the other chemicals. Store on sturdy shelves below eye level or in secure cabinets. Store separate from other hazard classes. Use highly toxic chemicals in a designated area or laboratory. Highly toxic chemicals that produce fume or dust should always be handled with a chemical fume hood. Next one, compressor gas. All compressor gas have a common in large amount of energy stored in the cylinder from the compression of the gas. Dropping or knocking over a cylinder can cause the energy to be rapidly released. Examples of compressor gases are helium is a chemical element with a symbol He and atomic number 2. It is a colorless, odorless, tasteless, non-toxic, inert, monoatomic gas. Next one, hydrogen is a chemical element with a symbol H and atomic number 1. Hydrogen is the lightest element. How to store these compressed gases safely? Incompatible gases must be separated by a 30-minute fire barrier or 20 feet or line of sight. Limit the quantity of compressed gas cylinders on site to what will be used within a reasonable period of time. Keep cylinders away from heat and open flames. Store cylinders upright. Leave the wall protection cap on the cylinder unless it is in use. Availability of soap solution to check the cylinder leak by noting where the bubbles appear. Explosives. Explosive chemicals can rapidly release tremendous amount of destructive energy. Explosive chemicals can cause death, serious injury, or severe property damage. Examples of explosives are trinitrotoluene, more commonly known as TNT, is a chemical compound with a formula C6H2NO2 thrice and CH3. And ammonium nitrate is a chemical compound with a chemical formula NH4NO3. How to store this explosive safely? Identify all the explosive and potentially explosive chemicals in your inventory. Consider designated a special area to store the use of potentially explosive chemicals. For chemicals that may degrade to become potentially explosive, record the opening date and discard date directly into the container. Keep explosive chemicals away from all ignition sources, open flames, hot surfaces, direct sunlight, spark sources. Store explosive chemicals in an explosive magazine and inspect areas weekly. Make sure everyone who uses explosives or potentially explosive chemicals is thoroughly trained in safe storage methods. 7th one, cryogens. These materials are extremely cold, -100°C to -270°C. Upon contact with cryogenic materials, living tissue can freeze and become brittle enough to shatter. Additional hazards include rapid pressure buildup, oxygen enrichment, and asphyxiation. Examples of cryogens are liquid nitrogen, LN2, is a nitrogen in a liquid state with low temperature. Liquid methane is used in industrial chemical process and may be transported as a refrigerant liquid. How to store these cryogens safely? Store and handle in a well-ventilated area. When liquid cryogens are converted to a gaseous phase, they may create an oxygen deficiency. Use only approved storage vessels with pressure relief mechanisms. Secure containers so they will not tip over or obstruct hallways or corridors during earthquake. Liquid nitrogen and liquid helium are capable of liquefying oxygen from air. And use appropriate personal protective equipment for handling cryogens, insulated holders for carrying vessels. Next one, water reactive chemicals. Water reactive chemicals react violently with water, releasing heat and in some cases explosive byproducts. All alkali metals react vigorously, that is exothermically, with water to form hydroxide, liberating hydrogen gas. The heat generated from the reaction can ignite the hydrogen, resulting in explosion. Examples of water reactive chemicals of sodium is a chemical element with the symbol of Na and atomic number 11. It is a soft, silvery white, highly reactive material. Phosphorus is a chemical element with a symbol P and atomic number 15. How to store these water reactive chemicals safely? Store in a cool, dry place. Keep away from the water. In case of fire, do not use water. Store all metals in a container provided by the manufacturer. Use secondary containment. Keep away from light and free from extreme of temperatures and humidity and away from a watery source. Store alkali metals under mineral oil or an inert atmosphere. Note lithium reacts with nitrogen. Consider the use of drying agents and desiccators where appropriate. Do not store under the sink. Last one, pyrophoric chemicals. Substances that ignite spontaneously upon the contact with air. A substance is pyrophoric if it ignites spontaneously in air at below 54 degrees centigrade within 5 minutes after coming to contact with air. Examples of pyrophoric are sodium is a very soft silvery white metal. Sodium is the most alkali metal, comprising 2.8% of earth crust. Diboron, generally known as diboron, it is chemical compound consisting of boron and hydrogen with a formula of B2H6. How to store pyrophoric chemicals safely? Pyrophoric chemicals must be stored under an atmosphere of inert gas. Containers must be clearly labeled with the correct chemical name and hazard warning. Do not allow pyrophoric chemicals stored in solvent to dry out. Do not return excess chemical to the original container and store in cool, dry place. Prevent contact with air. This is about the safe storage of different types of chemical classes. Let me brief the storage instructions. Label storage areas according to the type of chemical family or hazard classification found there. Inspect storage areas regularly. Keep storage areas well ventilated and at consistent cool temperature. Eliminate ignition sources such as open flames, heat sources, or direct sunlight. Keep emergency equipment such as fire extinguishers, eye showers, or bottles nearby. Confine chemical storage areas so that leak spills are controlled. Prevent chemicals from running down sink, floor, or storm water drains. Clean up spills and dips immediately. Don't store chemicals in a sink or fume hood, except for certain toxic gases that are so dangerous they can only be stored in a gas cabinet or fume hood. This is about the safe storage of chemicals. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and share my videos. Once again, thanks for watching. Have a safe day.